HIV transmission through a small cut and best HIV test. Hello, Mark Medicals here again teaching about HIV infection, HIV symptoms, HIV treatment, and HIV testing. Today, let us answer these 9 questions from you, our viewers. Question 1. Can you get HIV from a small drop of blood? Question 2. How can you contract HIV through a cut? Question 3. Can HIV enter through scratch? Question 4. What is considered an open wound for HIV transmission? Question 5. What happens if someone else's blood gets in your cut? Question 6. Is HIV transmission through a small cut possible? Question 7. What is a needle stick injury? Question 8. Can you get HIV by kissing? Question 9. What is the best HIV test? Note that you can easily jump and see the answer to the question of your choice. Also, if you want to know if you have HIV type 1 or type 2, see videos linked in the description section below this video. Alright. Let us start with question 1. Can you get HIV from a small drop of blood? The answer is yes, you can get HIV infection from a small drop of blood. This is because a small drop of blood visible to your eye could be containing millions of viruses capable of infecting a person. However, there is almost no risk of HIV infection if the blood drops on intact skin with no wounds. According to CDC, the average risk of HIV infection after a needle stick or cut exposure to HIV-infected blood is 0.3%, that is 1 in 300. Stated another way, 99.7% of needle stick or cut exposures do not lead to infection. Also, CDC says that the risk after exposure of the eye, nose, or mouth to HIV-infected blood is estimated to be, on average, 0.1% or 1 in 1,000. From the same studies, CDC reports that the risk after exposure of non-intact skin to HIV-infected blood is estimated to be less than 0.1%. A small amount of blood on intact skin probably poses no risk at all. There have been no documented cases of HIV transmission due to exposure involving a small amount of blood on intact skin, or a few drops of blood on the skin for a short period of time. Question 2. How can you contract HIV through a cut? What you should know is that HIV is transmitted when a person who has measurable amounts of the virus in their body passes fluids directly into the bloodstream or through mucous membranes, cuts, or open sores of a person without HIV. From the cut wound, the virus will be washed off by flowing blood, and this is a way by which the virus will be able to locate and infect your CD4 cells. Question 3. Can HIV enter through scratch? According to PubMed, the risk of HIV infection from scratches and bites is almost zero. But if the scratch is somehow deeper or involves bleeding, then definitely there is a risk of HIV infection. If you have had any blood spill onto your eyes, skin, or anywhere, Mark Medicals recommends splashing lots of water on the exposed area, and please speak to your doctor about HIV prevention medications, also called HIV treatment PEP. Question 4. What is considered an open wound for HIV transmission? Any wound of any potential size carries a risk of HIV infection. HIV can enter only through an open cut or sore, or through contact with the mucous membranes in the anus and rectum, the vagina, the genitals, the mouth, and the eyes. So if the massage involved penetrative sex without a condom, an infectious body fluid might have contact with mucous membranes in the genital area. If you have any wound of any size, avoid doing any household chores or touching blood-stained objects unless your wound is properly covered or dressed. Though handling food carries almost no risk of HIV infection, there are other diseases that you can spread to others if your infected blood is mixed with food. Question 5. What happens if someone else's blood gets in your cut? If you have contact with a person's blood or body fluids, you could be at risk of HIV, hepatitis B, or hepatitis C, or other blood-borne illnesses. Body fluids, such as sweat, tears, vomit, or urine may contain and pass on these viruses when blood is present in the fluid, but the risk is low. Additionally, consider getting HIV PET medication in less than 72 hours if you had an HIV exposure, like after unprotected intercourse and sharing injecting equipment. Question 6. What is a needle stick injury? Needle stick injuries are wounds caused by needles that accidentally puncture the skin. Needle stick injuries are common in people who work with injection syringes and other needle equipment. These injuries can occur at any time when people use, disassemble, or dispose of needles. Health workers usually get these types of accidents as their occupational hazards, and if you are a tailor, then definitely you should have had one yourself. Question 7. How fast does HIV die in air? HIV is a fragile virus and dies within seconds when exposed to light and air. HIV can only be transmitted through direct contact with blood, semen, vaginal fluid, rectal fluid, or breast milk. In dried blood, HIV can only live for up to 6 days, so coming into contact with dry blood could easily put you at risk of HIV infection. Question 8. Can you get HIV by kissing? Although very rare, transmission can occur if both partners have sores or bleeding gums, and blood from the partner with HIV gets into the bloodstream of the HIV-negative partner. HIV is not transmitted through closed mouth or social kissing with someone who has HIV. HIV is not transmitted through saliva. Studies have shown that saliva has an enzyme that weakens and makes it non-infectious. So, kissing is very safe as far as HIV infection is concerned, but do not forget that there are other diseases that can be transmitted through kissing, like hepatitis, germs that cause peptic ulcers, the germ that causes cancer of the throat, and many others. Question 9. What is the best HIV test? If you have watched this video up to this point, all I have to say is thank you for being our fan and dedicated viewer. So, after exposure to HIV, you definitely need to have an HIV test. Not all HIV tests have the same accuracy and window period. As a health practitioner, the best HIV testing kit is the HIV RNA test, because it detects the physical virus. The downside of these HIV tests is that they are very expensive and not readily available in many centers, especially in developing countries. If you want to know your status before 6 weeks, better use fourth generation HIV kits, which detect HIV with an accuracy of more than 95 to 99% between 6 to 8 weeks, and around 100% at 3 months. Having said that, any HIV test done after 3 months is conclusive. So, do not repeat your negative test result if done after 3 months.